From the campus studios of Saarland University, this is Ropecast, a lighthearted podcast for learners of English, with Roger Charlton and Peter Tisha.
Hello, listeners, and welcome to the latest Ropecast, our podcast about the English language and everything connected with it. Hello, Peter.
Hello, Roger.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. I was kind of busy these days.
What were you doing?
I was watching the Olympics.
Oh, well, yeah. That yeah. keeps you busy because it's a lot of television.
Yeah, yeah. And you know, I have BBC television at home via satellite.
Right.
And you have something like 20 channels that the BBC put on, so you can watch everything.
Yes. Though I rarely watch sport myself.
You don't?
No.
Well, I love it, actually. I don't do a lot of sports, but I love watching it. It's kind of hard as far as language goes sometimes, though.
I think it probably is. If you're not a native speaker of English, there are, even in the Olympics, there were some strange words.
Yeah. I mean, the commentary is hard already. Yes. They talk so fast.
Yeah.
But even when they announce what they're going to show, sometimes I have a little bit of trouble because the names of the disciplines are so weird.
Yeah. I came across one that I'd never heard before, and that was skeet.
Yeah, that's a shooting event.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's your fault. I mean, the British and the Americans' fault that you use names that are, well, I would say the words that you use for some disciplines to me sound rather rare. I mean, in German, we would just say Tontaubenschießen, clay pigeon shooting.
That's exactly what we say in Britain.
Ah, okay. So a skeet is probably a special clay pigeon?
I think that the word, anyway, must come from the USA.
Ah, okay. I see. Well, anyway, you'd have to understand that it's neither a pigeon, and it's probably not even made of clay, but it's actually a little disc that you have to shoot at.
Yes.
And it falls apart.
Well, we're familiar with the discipline, as it were, in Britain, mm-hmm. but not the word skeet.
To make it more difficult, there's another discipline. It's also clay pigeon shooting, which is called trap.
Ah, well, I don't know anything about that.
Yeah, difficult. Let's go to track and field.
You mean athletics?
Well, an American would say track and field. Okay. See how difficult it is? Well, anyway, the disciplines in track and field are sometimes hard to understand as well. Because, okay, 100-meter, 200-meter race, that's easy. That's right. Even beginner's English, if you ask me.
And but, long jump, high jump, what's the problem?
Yeah, but there's another kind of high jump that they call pole vault.
Yeah, well, that's not a jump. That's a vault.
Not well, in German, we don't make the difference. Jumping is jumping. Even if it's 6 meters or 2 meters, who cares?
Yeah, the difference here is that you're using something to go over the obstacle.
Uh-huh.
You're using a pole.
A pole.
Because uh-huh. I think the default reading for me, to use technical terms, if I use the word vault, it means I'm not just jumping, but I'm using something to help me to clear an obstacle.
But you'll have to admit it's not an everyday word.
Perhaps not as frequent as jump. Mm-hmm. I'll give you that.
Okay. Here's another one, kind of weird. A steeplechase is also a track and field discipline or an athletics discipline.
Right.
Know that?
Well, I think originally in the UK, probably in England mostly, people would get on a horse
mm-hmm.
and there would be competitors, other people on horseback. And they would say, let's see who's going to be first to reach that steeple in the distance.
That's a church tower originally.
Yeah, so they would just go across country on their horses, jumping everything that gets in the way
mm-hmm.
until the first arrived at the town or the village.
Uh-huh, okay.
At least that's what I imagine the origin to be.
It makes sense because there is, I think, still an event that is sort of a steeplechase. That's the cross-country event.
Well, it's used in horse racing. What we call the flat racing season, when mm-hmm. there are no obstacles, and then mm-hmm. there's steeplechasing, which is over okay. fences, mostly.
Yeah, but in athletics, that is without a horse mm-hmm. and without a steeple, it's just an obstacle race
right.
Of 3 kilometers.
Yeah. When I was at school, when we went running, if we were not on the athletics track, then we would go cross-country running, and again, we would have to deal with all kinds of obstacles.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I see.
So cross-country had that... Yeah. Meaning at school level.
Okay. Well, you know all these things, but just, you know, I'm still a German, so I look at the TV and they tell me, okay, here is the next event coming up, and you have a thing like javelin.
Yeah.
That's not a common word either. I would call that a spear.
Oof. I think a spear is different.
Mm-hmm.
First, size.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Javelin is small. It's a small, neat thing which you can use on the sports field.
It's a kind of a spear, a long stick with a pointed end that you throw.
Yes, yes. But if you say spear to me, then I think about maybe something coming back from a different continent where people still use that thing that you call a spear to catch fish.
Ah, okay.
They spear fish in the water.
Right.
But then I would say spear.
Ah, okay.
It's certainly not something you would use for a sporting event.
All right. Okay, I see. But, you know, there's a lot of those terms, don't you think, that are, at least to my mind, being a German, I think we use rather terms that can be easily interpreted.
With one exception that came to my mind immediately, and that is, this is in German, I heard the word military.
Yeah, that's sort of a multi-discipline horse event. You have to do a few things, but basically it's most important part is a cross-country horse riding event.
But there's dressage as well, isn't there? And
I believe
jumping.
So. I'm not entirely sure.
Well, there's an example where what for me a very strange word
but,
is used.
But actually, it's called Vielseitigkeit, so multi-talent event nowadays. What is it called in English? It's not called military.
That's eventing. The whole thing is eventing, or
the whole thing is eventing.
A 3-day event.
So you can event.
Yes, I suppose you can. If you have a horse.
If you have a horse, you can event.
Right.
Okay, I think our listeners have learned a lot from the Olympics now. Look, here's what we'll do. We'll put at least the most difficult disciplines online on our website, www.ropecast.de, and so everybody can follow the Olympics with enough language knowledge.
Fine, let's do that.
Okay, great. So let's just say goodbye and have fun watching. Bye-bye.
Bye.
You've been listening to Ropecast, brought to you by Saarland University, featuring Roger Charlton and Peter Tischer. Tune in for the next edifying episode on your podcast dial.